सो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू समथिंग वेरी डिफरेंट अप्रोच टू दिस, समस्याओं को रास्ता से निकाल देना, अगर चट्टान भी सामने आए तो टकरा जाए, समस्याओं को रास्ते से निकाल दे, रिमूव ऑल द ऑब्स्टेकल दैट कम इन योर वे, डोंट हेजिटेट टू गो एंड हिट द माउंटेन इटसेल्फ. That is the attitude you have to develop. So, very important thing is, what are the things that you should develop traveling towards your project? Abdul Kalam ji, whose birthday we are celebrating tomorrow. Let me tell you a referential story from him. His very first project as a project director in ISRO. He was given a project to launch SLV-3 into orbit. And you know, when the orbit was about to be launched, it just that they were counting down 10, 9, 8, 7, that they come down in the descending order. They came to the 4. The computer started telling that stop the launching because there is a leakage somewhere. And 6 experts sitting with him, scientists, he turned towards them. They discussed among themselves. They said, no leakage, don't fear, sir. Everything will be taken care of. We can just bypass this and proceed. And he took the responsibility and gave the order that, okay, let us launch. And from his own words, satellite, instead of going and settling down in orbit, it fell in Bay of Bengal. So that's a beginning of a great personality's development. When that failure happened, you know what happens? The leaders automatically get disturbed. But he was not disturbed because his leader, Satish Dhawanji, was much greater personality at that time. What he told him, that now that the press is waiting for all of you to, and you as the project director has addressed, just all of you know, because the project has failed, all of you please go back and relax. I will face the camera. And as a leader, Satish Dhawanji faced it and told everybody that we have not failed, but there was an error. Definitely we will correct, and next time we will ensure that we are in the orbit. And India is a big success story, and Abdul Kalam ji is a big success story because he became the father of India's intercontinental ballistic missile. So I read again a poem on this. Rakh himmat tufano se takrane ki. Rakh himmat tufano se takrane ki. Jarurat nahi ki musibat ko dekh ke ghabrane ki. Jarurat nahi kisi musibat ko dekh ke ghabrane ki. This is the attitude Kalamji developed. And one thing, whenever I had opportunity to meet him, few of the instances, one good quote which he has always told me, that teach the children that to have a dream which keeps them awake, not allow them to sleep. Tell the children, tell the students, when you go to the colleges, university, schools, everywhere you're going, Acharyaji, you inform them in your talk that their dream which they are nurturing into them, their mind, that should keep them awake, not allow them to sleep. Then only they will be successful. People who wanted to travel to the destination of success, they should be prepared for certain things. The best preparation they should have, that they should be ready that they'll be rejected. They should be insulted. They will be criticized. Their ideas will not be accepted. Everybody will start pulling your leg. If you want to succeed, you have to overcome all this. You just cannot stay there, because you remember the childhood days, the rabbit and the tortoise race. What happened in that? What we more correctly say, hare and tortoise. Hare is more confident, it can run fast. But tortoise, he says, yes, I don't mind being defeated. You run fast, but I will compete with you. The confidence of tortoise was never understood by hare. He was overconfident. When the race started, he went very fast. And so fast that tortoise behind was not visible. So he said, let him come relaxly. When he comes near, we'll see. Then he went under a tree and relaxed. But unfortunately, hare slept. And the result is, tortoise became number one. So success is not something that is, you know, it's a package given as a formula to you and you will just put it into your laptop and become successful. Success requires many things. It requires an attitude. It requires a burning desire. It requires a burning desire. It requires the ability to face rejection. It requires you to be very competent. It requires you to shun your ego. You should not carry your ego. And you should be in a position to relinquish your comfort zone. Your comfort zone, you must relinquish. And you must know how to manage your time. 24 hours is most important thing that is available with you. And your focus should be only on your mission. I can tell you, you will never be a failure. Because in any race, if 9.5 second is the fellow who achieved in the 100 meter, the first person, the second would have got it 9.4. The third would have got it 9.3. The fourth would have also got just 9.25. It's a fraction difference. Don't consider this as a failure. Always remember, Steve Jobs was necked out from Apple. And the same guy was returned back to Apple to give you one of the best products in the international market. So there are many such people who tells us that better read the stories of failure than successful. So I will just tell you, life is an adventure. It is never easy. Therefore, don't expect any miracles. Be resilient. Be resilient. Aptly use your time. Be patient. Move on step by step. Do not ever quit till you reach your goal. Move on and on. Life is for a warrior. Life is for a warrior. And for a warrior, success is always waiting to hug. Success is always waiting to hug. Understand these factors. They're very, very important for you. So to conclude, I can only tell you, success is not something that you run in by accident. It takes a lot of preparation. And character. Everyone likes to succeed, but most people do not willing to give their 100%. It is the preparation that makes you successful. There is no substitute for hard work. The harder you work, the luckiest you are. The average person gives his 24-25% only. But the person who succeeds, he is the one who gives 50% more than others. And the whole world stands and removes their hat and says, hey, you did it. We have many examples, so there is no, it will not be justifying just taking few names. So I will just conclude by giving you just a simple one more, as usual, one good poem so that you really understand what I wanted to sum up. Phool biche hai. तो काटे होंगे राह ना अपनी छोड़ देना फूल बिछे हैं तो काटे होंगे राह ना अपनी छोड़ देना चाहे कितनी भी विपदाएं चाहे कितनी भी विपदाएं आए मुख को कभी मोड़ना नहीं साथ कोई तेरा दे या ना दे साथ कोई तेरा दे या ना दे हिम्मत मगर ना छोड़ना हिम्मत मगर ना छोड़ना नहीं कृपा की भीख मांगना नहीं कृपा की भीख मांगना बस ईश्वर पे भरोसा करना बस ईश्वर पे भरोसा करना जब तक जान है तन में जब तक जान है तन में तब तक आगे बढ़े चलो हिम्मत से आगे बढ़े चलो थैंक यू वेरी मच
Thank you so much, sir. It's been wonderful listening to you. And I think it's really wonderful the way you put up everything, that how the person can be successful, quoting a lot of people who can be our role models. And continuing with this ahead is Fauzia Fatima is going to tell us a story, adding to whatever sir has talked about, so that it's very clear for everybody that how you can be successful in life. Over to you, Fauzia Fatima.
Thanks, Usha ma'am. So friends, get ready for the story. Okay, all are ready. So I will be sharing my screen and let's get into the world of beautiful stories. All right. Okay, here we go. Get ready. 10, 9, 8, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Usha ma'am, can you see my screen?
No, we can't see your screen.
Okay, let's try again, all right? And Manju ma'am, can you help me with this?
Yeah, sure. Fauzia, just try one more time.
Sure, ma'am. Okay, let's see whether the magic will happen, okay?
No visible video is there, only audio is coming.
Yes, so I have switched off the video so that I can share the screen.
Okay, Fauzia, just try, just try this time. Otherwise, I'll just present it.
Manjuman, can you see now?
Not yet.
Okay, so Manjuman, you have to help me now.
Yeah, sure. One second.
Friends, get ready, all right? The amazing world of stories. And I have switched off my camera, but you can hear my voice, right? Good. So Manju ma'am will help me. All right, to get into the world of stories. Yes, I can see. Friends, you all can see, right? Okay. Ma'am, can you play the slide?
Increase the screen.
Yes, now I can see. Friends, you all can see, right? Now let's start. Okay, thank you, Manju ma'am. So friends, today I'm going to tell you the story about a scientist, a very hardworking scientist. Finally, it was time for the launch of SLV-3. Yes, my friends, this scientist and all his team members worked for 7 long years to make this event happen. They all were very excited. Yes, now let's see what happens next. Manju ma'am, let's see what happens next. All right, they all were...
Next one, Manju.
Ready. Yes, ma'am.
Ready. Let's see, friends, what happens, okay? SLV-3, India's first satellite.
What happened, Manju?
Ma'am, 1 second.
Relatively, otherwise I'll share the screen.
Have you all seen rocket? Yes. Now let's see what happens to the rocket, okay? Get ready. All right. Yes, ma'am. So friends, can you see? All the team members and the scientists were working very hard to launch this SLV-3. Now, friends, let's all count together, okay? The rocket gonna launch. Let's start counting. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Manju ma'am, lift off. Yes! Friends, look. The rocket went above very fast. Zoom! It reached the first stage successfully. And all the team members were happy, but they were anxiously waiting. What will happen next? Manju ma'am, let's see what happens next. Let's see. Oh, they all look worried. The scientist and his team. Friends, let's see what happens to the rocket, Manju ma'am. Oh my God, I am also worried. What will happen to the rocket? Let's see. Where is the rocket? Friends, can you see rocket? I'm searching. Let's all search. Where is the rocket? Did it reach up in the sky? We will see. We will see now. Look, look, look. They all look so worried, Manju ma'am. Let's see what happens next. My God, where is the rocket? Friends, can you see rocket? I am searching. Manju ma'am is also searching, okay? Where is the rocket? Manju ma'am is helping. Where is the rocket, Manju ma'am? Let's find. It looks like dark sky, right? I'm trying to search. Oh, look, 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 my friends. Now the rocket is crashing down into the sky. Oh, the rocket, the flight is terminated. Oh my God, look. The scientist and his team are very sad and disappointed. They all worked so hard for 7 years, right? But see what happened. The rocket crashed into the sea. And with this, all their hopes also drowned with it. So sad, right? All right, Manju ma'am, let's see what happens next. And you know what happened? When this rocket was launched and it didn't work, you know, there was a big press conference. All the people from newspapers, from different news channels, they came and asked, what happened? Why didn't the rocket fly up in the orbit? What happened? Tell us the reason. The scientist was feeling very sad and he felt he is responsible for the crash. He was feeling so sad. He worked hard, but it didn't happen. He thought everybody will now tell you are responsible. Your team did not work properly. He was thinking everybody will blame his team and him. Look how sad he is looking. Very sad, right? Now let's see what happens. Then, friends, his chairman, Professor Satish Dhawan, comes and he tells, I will answer all your questions. Please come to me. And then he told, all right, friends, this mission was very difficult. Now we need to find out the reasons what went wrong. And we should work on that. We should correct it. And then we should see that the mistakes are not repeated. And you know, Professor Satish Dhawan also told, friend, very confidently he told, in a year's time, we will launch another satellite successfully in the orbit. We all will work together and will make it happen. Listening to this, our scientist was very happy and he got inspired. Yes, my team and I will work even harder and we will make it happen. Now let's see what happens. He was feeling very tired, right? He was working so hard day and night. So it's time for Mr. Scientist to come and, you know, take some rest. All right, let's see what happens next. And the next day, again, he starts working. He works day and night, makes India's first satellite, SLV, that is Satellite Launch Vehicle, to again happen. In a year's time, again, satellite was ready, was prepared to launch. Friends, now let's all watch together what happens to this new satellite, which was prepared again. Let's find out, okay? Friends, are you ready to count with me? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Lift it off.
It's lifted off.
So friends, SLV-3, India's first satellite, was this time successfully placed into orbit. And India got a place in the elite group of countries who can launch satellites. Friends, this was a very proud moment for the scientists and his team and also all Indians. We all, yes, my friends. And this was, you know, It came in the newspapers, it came in the news channels, NDTV India, Aaj Tak, everyone showed that India has made its entry into the elite group of countries who can launch satellites. Now look how happy they are. Mr. Scientist and his team are rejoicing. This was the proudest and the happiest moment for them, the happiest event for them. And now it's time for Manju ma'am, let's see what happens. You know what happened? Mr. Scientist was lifted off, yes, on the shoulders of his colleague, and they paraded him around the launching pad. They all were laughing, rejoicing. Yes, we did it. It's a teamwork, hard work. They all were so happy. Now it's time for, remember, press conference happens now. Now, Mr. Scientist and Professor Satish Dhawan were in the press conference. Professor Satish Dhawan said, Mr. Scientist, it's your turn to speak. Mr. Scientist was feeling very happy that his professor gave him the opportunity to speak, because Professor Satish Dhawan knew how hard Mr. Scientist had worked and his team had worked for this event to happen. And you know what? Mr. Scientist was feeling very happy about his professor. Remember, when this mission failed, Professor Satish Dhawan spoke, right? Now, Professor Satish Dhawan is asking Mr. Scientist to speak. Seeing this, Mr. Scientist thought, yes, I will also become a good leader like him. Manju ma'am, let's see what happens next. And then Mr. Scientist thought, yes, like how Professor Satish Dhawan took the responsibility, took the blame of the failure, right? He did not say, oh, you did it. No, it was a teamwork. And when the mission was successful, he shared with his team. So friends, a good leader takes up the responsibility when something goes wrong and shares the success with his team. And Mr. Scientist also thought, yes, I will also become a good leader and I will do the same way. Now let's see what happens. Friends, now you all know who is the Mr. Scientist. Manju ma'am, can you just slide it so that we can see the name? Can
you read the name, my friends? My favorite, Abdul Kalam ji.
Yes, Usha ma'am. We are talking about, this story was about APJ Abdul Kalam, the 11th president of India. Manju ma'am, just slide, there are some adjectives. Friends, he was a great teacher, a scientist, a role model, and also a great leader. So friends, did you see what happened? Did you see what happened? First, there was failure. Abdul Kalam ji turned the failure into success with his hard work, dedication, and willpower. So friends, it's a very good example, right? When we don't get good marks in the exam, will we be sad? Oh, I cannot do it. No, we're going to get back and start working even harder, right? That's how Mr. Abdul Kalam did, right? All right. So friends, this was about our 11th president of India, Abdul Kalam. Now, Usha ma'am and friends, I have, let me see whether you all can tell me what is this. Okay, I want to show you something. Friends, look, I have butterflies. Do you all like butterflies? I like butterflies. I'm sure you all like butterflies, right? So friends, I will tell you a story about two butterflies, all right? Can you see? Yes. This butterfly, yellow butterfly, is Goldie butterfly. Hi, Goldie. And there is pink butterfly. This pink butterfly is Pinky. Now you got the names right, Goldie and Pinky. So friends, in the beautiful garden of Ooty, there were so many butterflies. And one day, you know what happened? The teacher of the butterflies announced, "Students, get ready. There will be flying competition. And who comes first, they will get the trophy. Then what happened? All the butterflies started to practice. Oh, I want to win. I want to get the trophy. And our Goldie butterfly flies very, very fast. So Goldie butterfly said, I will not practice because I fly so well and nobody can come first. So Goldie butterfly was just sailing around without practicing. He was singing, he was playing in the garden. He did not practice. Goldie butterfly's mama came and told, "Goldie, please practice." Goldie said, "No, mama, I'm not going to practice because I am a good flyer. Nobody can beat me. I'm going to be first." Then mama said, "Goldie, this laziness is not good. Talent without hard work is of no use. So be careful, Goldie." And mama left, okay? And Goldie was laughing. "Ha, ha, ha, mama don't know. I come first. I fly very nice." Friends, it was the day for the competition. But let me tell you about Pinky as well. Friends, Pinky Butterfly was not very good in flying, okay? So he was practicing every day, day and night. He was flying. He was practicing, okay? And then the day, the big day, that is the competition day, arrives and everybody gets ready. Yes, it was a big competition for all the butterflies, okay? Who flies faster, they get the trophy. So friends, are you ready? We will say on your mark, get set, go, okay? Tell with me. Who reaches the finishing line first, they win. So friends, all the butterflies were in the starting line, okay? Now they have to reach the finishing line. Let's say, on your mark, get set, go. All the butterflies started to fly. "I want to be first." They started to fly. Then Goldie Butterfly and Pinky Butterfly were flying very, very fast, faster than other butterflies. Now there was the finishing line, just few distance away. They both were head to head, flying. And suddenly, you know what happened? Pinky Butterfly, the butterfly which was practicing every day, reached the finishing line first. Yay! And the Goldie Butterfly was watching. Oh my God. Friends, did you see the Pinky Butterfly which practiced and practiced? Won the trophy. Yes, the Goldie Butterfly is the winner because he practiced. Here comes our Goldie, the Pinky Butterfly is the winner. The Goldie Butterfly was very sad. Then comes Mama. Mama tells, "Did you see, Goldie? Pinky Butterfly was confident and also he practiced. He worked hard. That's why he won." This event made the Goldie Butterfly understand the importance of hard work. Friends, we have the talent, but we need to practice. We need to work harder. We can be confident, but not overconfident. So friends, Goldie Butterfly learned a lesson and next time he was careful and he practiced to win. Okay? Winning, sometimes we lose. It's okay. But we need to work hard and try our best. So here's Goldie and Pinky for you. Yay. Thank you, Shaman.
Really, really wonderful. It was such a beautiful story. And we really loved it. And I think Sir will like to add something to it. Over to you, Sir, to add something to the entire moral of the story. You started the success story. And as you all know that Sri Abdul Kalam Ji's birthday, our favorite, the president of the country, his birthday tomorrow. So definitely, sir, will like to add something to it and talk about success. It is not only the great leaders who have been successful, and he'll definitely give us tips how to become successful. Over to you, sir.
First of all, the story we started is from my side on SLV3, Faujiaji continued it. That's a good coincidence.
Yes, sir, when I was thinking.
See, as if we both spoke and did it, everybody will think that we have discussed, but actually I don't know what you're speaking and you don't know what I'm speaking. So that shows the spirit when it is in the perfection, then everything else goes in the right direction. Now, as per this Abdul Kalamji story is concerned and Satish Dhawan story is concerned, what do you learn as a moral? The moral value behind it is, whenever there is a failure, as a leader, you face it. Even in family issues, even in your personal official issues, anywhere, whenever failure is there, as a leader, you go and face it. That is what Satish Dhawan has taught Abdul Kalam. He went on to tell this story in every university platforms and every lecture wherever he has given. Ultimately, it is a video which is in big viral circulation. But the second thing he said is, when there is a success, the leader should never be in the front. He should always go back. This is a big moral lesson. All we see in politicians today, everybody works, but the politician takes the credit. The present trend is that. But actually, there is an IAS officer working, there is a different officials working. The team should have been given credit in everything. So whoever is listening to this, let me make it very clear that you are a successful man without your wife's support is not possible. You are a successful man without the support of your parents, it's not possible. There is an unknown contribution, and that contribution is the greatest. 50% of our success, from behind we get support of our teachers, our friends, and our leaders and our peers. If you see this, that is what Satish Dhawan has told. So I'm very happy, and tomorrow is his birthday. He has been my favorite leader and I had very humble opportunities, yes, many times to spend more than 12 to 13 hours with him, learning many things. And till date, the mission is on. Kalamji is always alive in the hearts of all the students and all the youngsters of India, because he is the one who said by 2020, India will be on the top of the world. And today, we are knocking at the door of everybody, because everybody is now understanding that India is an unconquerable country, a great country, a country of 84 crores youth who can do wonders. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. It's a pleasure.
Ushaji, I want one question. Ushaji, one question from my side. That question is, what is the full name of Abdul Kalam? Let everybody, anybody tell.
Yes.
APJ Abdul Kalam, I want the full name.
Manju Chakravarti, the first question is asked by sir already. You can Manju.
Okay, so I repeat the question that Acharya ji has put up. What is the full form of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam? The full form of APJ. Please type it in the chat box.
I will tell the correct one, no problem.
I think, sir, you have to say us.
His full name is, you can note down with spelling, Awul Fakir Jainaluddin Abdul Kalam. A-V-U-L, Awul, P-A-K-I-R, Fakir, and Jain, J-A-I-N-U, Jainaluddin, L-A-B-D-N, Abdul Kalam.
Thank you, Guruji.
Because many
this
people
is very enlightening.
Manju Chakravarti, please go ahead and ask questions and fastest finger as well as the contest questions.
Sure, ma'am.
And Fazia, your story was excellent. Carry on.
I have a small request. Huh? give me way out because I have my prayer time. I will go for my prayer.
Sure, sir.
Thank you. I have done my job. So thank you very much. Sorry to leave little early.
So the next fastest finger question for this evening is, Guruji, in the starting of his conversation, mentioned about a small poem as he usually does it. So in today's poem, there was a line, dash tyag de. What was that he mentioned? What to tyag? He mentioned that we need to sacrifice something in order to achieve success. Can anyone tell me what is that word? Absolutely correct. I believe it's Tanuja who has mentioned the answer, laziness. Great work. I mean, Preeti, Ajit, you all have also mentioned the correct answer. So congratulations. Coming back to the next question of the evening. So what was the name of the satellite? What was the name of the satellite that was launched? Kindly type it in the chat box. Okay, SLV3. All right, Tanuja. Good effort, Ajitji. Even you have mentioned the correct answer. Coming to the next question, the name of the leader who was heading the entire team of the satellite mission, the name of the leader. The name of the leader who was heading the entire satellite mission. I need the full answer. No, Tanuja, it was not Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam ji. Kavi, can you please mention the full name? All right. So Kavi and Tanuja, you both are right. Kavi just mentioned, missed mentioning the first half of the name. That is Satish Dhawan, sir. All right. The next question. Tell me the, the very unique name that India has given to APJ Abdul Kalam, sir. The other name that there is a name that we call him. Apart from Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, there is a very common name that we address him with. Can you tell me what is that name? A tag that is given to him. Absolutely correct, Ajit. It's Missile Man. The name that we Indians have given him is Missile Man. Absolutely correct. So that is the end of the fastest finger for this evening. Now coming back to the contest. We all know that tomorrow is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam ji's birthday. So you all are inspired. Like Acharya ji mentioned that he's also inspired by his story. Each one of us is inspired by APJ Abdul Kalam, sir. So the contest is here that you need to pick up one quote. There are so many quotes given by Dr. APJ. So you need to pick up one quote and take any of the story that has motivated you, any success story motivated you, or probably it has any particular quote that has motivated you. You need to narrate it in a story format and share it with us. I repeat that each one of us is inspired by some or the either role model in our life, just like today we have discussed about APJ. So that you need to pick up one such success story that has motivated you, or probably your own success story. You need to narrate it and share the video with us. I'll share the Facebook link. The process is same. Either you put it on your Facebook and tag TGSB, or you come to TGSB page and put up a video with your name.
Perfect. That's what you have to do. And that's fantastic. The questions were good. And I think the story was also good. And I'm sure about it that everybody will take a cue of how to become successful. And there is nothing called impossible, as in word impossible itself says, I am possible. So I think that should be the motto of us. And we should be always thinking positive. And thinking positive will make us take us forward in life. and definitely make her successful. Right, Fauzia? Yes. And the stories was fantastic. Thank you so much, everybody who had joined us today. It was a wonderful Katha Sangra. Sir had to leave it early because of certain commitments, but it was really beautiful. Everything was put up very well. Thank you, Manu Chakravarti, to have coordinated the entire show. Thank you so much.